You're watching Star Television Network. I am Phebean Swill with a local news bulletin for the hour. First in the news, the headlines. Africa Youth Coalition Against Hunger, ACAF, with support from Action Aid International Sierra Leone, has held a symposium on sustainable land management. As the new apostolic church doles out food and non-food support to underprivileged children, the Network for Children in Need Orphanage Home at the Allentown community pleads for accommodation so that the children could not be thrown out in the street. And in sport, the Sierra Leone National Scrabble Association has been officially launched, marking it the 32nd sporting discipline under the National Sports Council. Those were the headlines, and now for the news in detail. Coalition Against Hunger, ACA, with support from Action Aid International Sierra Leone, on Friday held a one-day symposium to launch a research report on four key steps to prevent land grabs. For the past 10 years, tens of millions of acres of land have been acquired by large-scale investors in developing countries, including Sierra Leone. Land grab remains principal in the report that has been launched. Our correspondent, Mohamed Kone, has more.
Access to and control over land and natural resources is crucial to people's livelihood. It also ensures the rights to food, water, work, housing, and a healthy environment. Government and donor institutions have the opportunity and responsibility to ensure that policies and action contribute to land rights, as contained in this report. Mohamed Sila is the country director, Action Aid International Sierra Leone.
These are four steps we can take that will prevent the whole concept of having conflict in land investment. Okay, we are just sharing in this book, sharing examples of what has worked in other countries. I'm sure, and that was even the perspective that the parliamentarians welcomed, that we're not going to tell them all our policies are bad and this and that, but we are actually proposing that let us consider these 4 points. They can be very useful in helping us to actually look at what are the key issues we need to do that can prevent issues around land grab.
Women remain key in every development, and the need for their voices to be heard and policies that affect their very lives. This report takes into cognizance the role of women and the daily struggle they undergo as a result of lack of access to land. Chief Ya Almamitue is president of Women Farmers in the Western area.
I think land grabbing in Sierra Leone is not a new issue. Land grabbing in Sierra Leone is being extended every day to rural women, and we are the most sufferers. You can just imagine. Now Ebola has come, and they are almost going. The rebel came and they have gone. Women are the most vulnerable people for these two issues. Women, we are the women that produce 80% of the food consumption every day in any developing countries.
Land targeted for large-scale land deals is frequently labeled as idle, vacant, unused, or available by investors or government. However, research has shown that such land in reality are often used by women. But what is this land grabs? Dr. Samir Brahma, lecturer at the University of Sierra Leone, gives a description in this direction.
And the few things that have emerged over time is that land grab is becoming an international security situation. I want us to know that. Over the past 12 months, large-scale acquisition of farmland in Africa, Latin America, Central Asia, and Southeast Asia have made headlines in the flurry of media reports across the world. Well, for a time, lands were not influenced. They were just for inside issues, so people are not worried. But now we see international investors longing for tens of millions of hectares of land. In fact, in a study in 2004, you can imagine, in 5 countries, Ethiopia, Ghana, Madagascar, Mali, and Sudan, over 2,492,684 hectares have been approved for land acquisition.
The report titled Act on It presents an opportunity for activists on land rights to contribute to policy reforms, especially the ongoing constitutional review that is in progress. With these findings and results contained in this report, government is encouraged to urgently review and reform their land-related laws. For Star TV News, this is Mohammed Kone in Freetown.
Over the last few weeks, the New Apostolic Church has been reaching out to underprivileged groups of people, especially children with lots of support, with some food and non-food items. The team's gesture to 2 orphanage homes in the western area was witnessed by Patrick Salia, who now reports.
Everything went so, we cried for rescue, no one to help.
The donation countrywide, according to the New Apostolic Church's administrative clerk, Abdullahi Sano, amounts to 20,000 euros, which is equivalent to 100 million leones, basically spent on food items and educational materials, disbursed by a German businessman, Jörg Wolf, whose foundation has touched and changed the lives of many underprivileged people, especially in Africa.
We have 3 apostles, one in Southwest, we have the one in the North, and we have the one in the East. And they have many missionaries, church ministers, who are always going around preaching the gospel and also looking for those in need. So that is how we get our selection.
The faces of children at both receiving homes in the western area, urban and rural, represent need and an invitation for prompt assistance with frequency on the health, education, and perhaps some other social supports, because the kids have for some times now lived in a state of squalor and hopelessness after losing their parents or guardians to natural causes and some to the current Ebola outbreak. At the Children Redemption Orphanage Home within the Banga Farm community in Waterloo that started in 2003 with taking care of homeless and destitute area boys who had passion for football, Frank John Williams, the national director of the small center here, tells Star TV that the major challenges they are faced with at the moment that might affect their operations is feeding, clothing, and educational support.
Because these kids go to our schools, and they go to our private schools that have to pay school fees, that they have to eat 3 times a day, and then even the medication as well. And even clothing is one of our challenges as well.
And how do you get the support to take care of those things?
Well, I really tell God thank you, because I have like 4 or 5 friends like in the U.S. that normally at the end of the month, every little thing they can gather is why they can send. And I make use of that. And I can really appreciate God for the New Apostolic Church. This is not their first time of making such donation, right? It is uncountable.
Well, we are always making our assessment, and we are always presenting the case to our donors. And whenever we have funds available in that area, we can come in.
Here at the Network for Children in Need Orphanage Home at Miami Furniture Area within Allentown Community, east end of Freetown, there are provisions for health and education needs of especially physically challenged and destitute children, as well as children being orphaned by the Ebola epidemic and other causes. Social workers, past and present at this center, have been rendering such humanitarian aid for almost 4 decades now, unofficially, and officially with the Social Welfare Ministry, slightly more than a decade. But unfortunately, the tenants may have no choice soonest but to leave the building they have been paying rent for the past 5 years, to the tune of about 18 million leones a year.
These are one of the challenges for the house rent and feeding for the kids, and we have staffs that are working with us, which are 17 staff. And all these 17 staffs are on salaries. And you know, doing this kind of job, you are not going to depend solely on one partner. So like we asking, I as an operations manager, I'm really trying to reach out to people out, you know, to help, to come to the aid of these kids so that we can able to help these children.
Like the Bible preaches, that one must give thanks. The children praising not only for the new apostolic church's gesture, but also for God's love, guidance, protection, and provision in the midst of particularly the Ebola turbulence.
Finally, to round up our local news bulletin for the hour, we now join our sports correspondent, Hilton John.
The Sierra Leone National Scrabble Association has been officially launched at Party Street in Freetown, where its head office is situated, making it as the 32nd sporting discipline under the National Sport Council. Scrabble is an educative sporting activity that enhances the mental ability of an individual to think critically and improve the vocabulary, especially in word transposition. According to the Secretary General of the Scrabble Association, Trankoka, explains about some of their challenges they are facing since the association was put together for them to see how they can develop the sport itself. The vice president of the association, Sheku Bangua, noted that the association is appealing for an office space through the National Sport Council and the Ministry of Sport that is conducive for administrative purposes. The request for an office space is also extended to parastaters as they intend taking Scrabble to various learning institutions across the country. He explained more about the latest developments in the association.
Shepu Bangura, Vice President, National Scrabble Association, Sierra Leone.
Okay, what inspired you to form this association?
Well, Scrabble, I've been playing Scrabble for the past 20 years or more, and these have served to keep me going in terms of knowing words, improving my English and vocabulary. And therefore, I thought it fit that with other Scrabble players who have been playing for the game for over 20, 30 years, we came together and saw it fit that we need to bring the Scrabble game as one, that is, to form an association and then take it international, because we are very much aware of the fact that people have been playing Scrabble, but they have been playing it just for domestic purpose. And now we are taking Scrabble as a sporting discipline for which we will not only be limited to playing it at home, but rather taking it to schools, playing it at international level. Like now, we have the opportunity to be playing Scrabble at the Africa Scrabble Championship, World Scrabble Championship, etc., etc., as the case may be.
Okay, finally, why do you think that it is important for you to take Scrabble to the schools, universities, or other institutions?
Now, Scrabble has two basic things that it provides. In the first place, Scrabble is a mind game. That's the first thing we need to know. Because it is a mind game, one thing that Scrabble brings is it teaches you basic mathematics. It also teaches you basic English, how to spell, how to do basic addition and multiplication. And that we think will help a lot of our students, people, etc., etc.
It's indeed a pleasure for you to speak to the Star TV Sports.
Thank you, sir.
It could be recalled that scrabbling as a sporting discipline is a fairly new development within the current sporting arena that requires time to develop and match with other sporting disciplines in the country. It's in journal reporting for Star TV Sports.
And that's all in our local news bulletin on Channel 21 for the hour. I am Phebean Swill. Thank you for watching and stay tuned to Channel 21.